So IRR filters can be also implemented with integers, so they are called fixed point IRR filters. They're very useful, for example, on microcontrollers, or if you have very high sampling rate and floating point would be just too slow. So essentially everything is integer. Everything is in integer. So remember, the classic standard integer resolutions are the normal int in C++ or in C. That's usually 32 bits, and then we've got also the short int. That's usually 16 bits. So these are usually the integer representations what we have. And so now, if we think of the coefficients, so the coefficients, as before, need to be scaled up. Coefficients need to be for example, that they're using the 16 bits to the maximum, in its maximum range here, ideally, and then obviously also preventing overflows. So we come to that. We need to scale it up. And in terms of architecture, so we use the so-called direct form RT architecture for this filter. Direct form 1 architecture. Direct form 1 architecture for the IIR filter. Or more precisely, we do a chain of these direct form 1 architectures. So direct form is second order. And so we're creating a chain of direct form one filters. So at the end, that we have something like this is here one filter block, and this is here filter block. And then this is here, so that's our input, and that's our output here. That's an out here, output here, and that we have here our direct form one, direct form one, direct form one filter, and creating a chain. And so now we need to think of how do we implement these direct form filters.